connecting the Excel Web Access web part. Now, I mentioned a couple of times that the Excel Web Access web part supports connections, the normal web part connections that you would associate with any web part. One of the more common ways of using this is with filter connections. Their standard way of providing parameters. Now, we saw one way of providing parameters. Here's a different way of providing parameters, and a whole variety of parameters that you might choose to pass to this Excel Web Access web part. So there's a whole slew of filters that you'll see available in SharePoint 2007 that I would direct you to that list. I'll show you where that list is going to come up. And when you create these connections, the different filters can all send up to, well, provide one parameter to the Excel Web Access web part. So for example, you may have a drop down here that lets you choose among four different turbines. This might be a simple text entry. This is going to be an end time text entry. Each one is going to have a single or pass over to a single named parameter. And actually what we're doing when we make this configuration, we're actually sending the that passed information to a named range in the spreadsheet. So similar to what we did before, we're going to be using named ranges for this. So we'll take a look at how to configure it after I just demonstrate quickly. We'll look at this configuration from start to finish. So here's what I'm talking about. I've got this tag sinusoid I'm retrieving currently, but now over here I have got a filter. This is a simple text filter. Now this is different than these parameters that we were looking at here. If you recall, we were supporting using parameters here, and we still support that, of course. But now I've added a text filter, and that text filter has been configured such that when I enter a value and press return, we're going to send that value off here. And as you can see, it's now changed that by pointing to that named range. Now, Excel is smart here. When you decide to choose an overlapping configuration in which either a parameter could be presented or you could do it through a filter, well, if you configure a filter, then you'll notice that the parameter removes itself from that list automatically. So I didn't have to do anything to make this remove from the list. So this is that same web part that we were looking at in our previous example that had the tag name there.